Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Can we have the register confirm quorum and number of proxies, please, before we commence?
Good morning, Mr. Chairman. For the purpose of this meeting, the AGM, the registrars received a total of 127 valid proxy forms representing the equivalent number of shareholders who are not able to attend this meeting physically, and who also amongst them hold a total of 987,424,062 ordinary shares of ADOVA PLC, which represents 75.34% of the company's shareholding. Mr. Chairman, in compliance with the provisions of the section 233 and 256 of the CAMA, which requires 1/3 of the total number of members of the company or 25 members, whichever is less, present in person or by proxy for the formation of quorum for the meeting of the company, I hereby confirm that the proxy is formed for the meeting to commence. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Let's put this meeting in the hands of God. I'd like to invite Mr. Patrick Ajudua to give us an open prayer.
Our God and our Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the gathering of our company at this year's annual general meeting. We thank you, O Lord, that you have made us to be a partaker of this gathering. Despite the circumstances we have found ourselves in the country, we did not allow death or sorrow to occur. Father, we appreciate you. We thank you for the survival of our company, that despite this situation, our company is still surviving and growing, O Lord, in great number. We thank you, O Lord, for the shareholders. We thank you, Lord, for our businesses. We pray and commit this meeting to the hand. We ask, O Lord, that you commence with us, that you be with us, that you guide us, and you lead us in our deliberation. We pray that all that we are going to do will be to your own glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Shareholders, ladies and gentlemen, here present and those joining us online, it is with great pleasure that I welcome you to the 42nd annual general meeting of our company. Please be informed that due to the safety challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic and the government's directive on restriction of large gatherings, the company has obtained approval of the Corporate Affairs Commission to hold this meeting by proxy. This meeting is being streamed live to our shareholders, regulators, and observers not physically present. We have the confirmation of the registrars that the meeting has been duly convened and properly constituted, and that there is present a proper quorum as required by the company's articles of association. I now declare this meeting open. May I introduce my colleagues here with me today? To my far left is Mr. Mohammed Aminu Omar. Next to him are Mr. Moshood Olajide, the CFO, Mr. Olumide Adeosun, the CEO. To my far right is Mr. Olushola Adeyo, and next to him, Mrs. Aniola Durosumieti, and Mr. Oladeinde Nelson Cole, the company secretary. Finally, my humble self, Abdul Wasi Shoami, your chairman. May I also introduce the representatives of the Nigerian Stock Exchange, Mrs. Lillian Dako. Okay. She's online. Securities and Exchange Commission, also online. Financial Reporting Council and the Corporate Affairs Commission, I believe they're all online. And the representatives of our external auditors, led by Mr. Femi Abegunde. The registrars, led by Mr. Oguchukwu Okunkwo. And the representatives of the shareholders on the audit committee, Mr. Job Ihejirika, Mrs. Adebisi Bakare, Mr. Safi Okonla, and the representatives of the management of Adova PLC. The register of the directors holding and the attendance of the board meetings is available for inspection in compliance with Section 301, Subsection 8 of the Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020. To facilitate the smooth conduct of our meeting, I would like to explain briefly that you would have an opportunity to second each resolution put to the meeting. Thereafter, I must emphasize that comments will be invited on that resolution only before the vote on it is taken. I will therefore request that those who wish to speak should indicate by raising their hands. Please, when called upon to speak, state your names clearly before you make your comments. One of our ushers will hand you a microphone for your comment, as advised by the health officials. We are enjoined to respect the COVID protocols. Shareholders who wish to ask questions and are encouraged to make it brief to give others the opportunity to ask their own questions. I call upon the company secretary to read the notice of the year 2020 AGM convening this meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, distinguished shareholder representatives, and I will also write on the existing protocol. Notice of Annual General Meeting. Notice of 42nd Annual General Meeting. Notice is hereby given that the 42nd Annual General Meeting PLC will hold at Odudua Hall, Southern Sun Hotel, 47 Alfred Riwane Road, Ikoyi, Lagos, on Monday, 12 April 2021 at 10 a.m. to transact the following business. Ordinary business. To lay before the members the audited financial position with the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income for the year ended 31st December 2020. The reports of the directors and the reports of the auditors and statutory audit committee thereon. Two, to declare a dividend. Three, to re-elect Mrs. Aniola Durosimieti to the board of directors as a director whose term expires in accordance with Articles 88 and 89 of the company's Articles of Association, but being eligible, offers herself for re-election. Four, to authorize the directors to fix the remuneration of the external auditors for the 2021 financial year. Five, to elect or re-elect the members of the Statutory Audit Committee. Six, to disclose the remuneration of managers of the company. Special business. To fix the remuneration of the directors. To consider and if thought fit pass the following as ordinary resolutions, that pursuant to Article 79 of the Articles of Association, the company be and is hereby authorized to raise capital in an aggregate amount not exceeding 60 billion naira through the issuance of shares, convertible or non-convertible securities, loan notes, bonds, global depository notes, and any other instrument, whether as a standalone or through the establishment of a program, whether by way of a public offering, rights issue, or any other methods, in such tranches, series, or proportions, and at such dates and times, and on such terms and conditions, including through a book building process or any other process as may be determined by the directors, subject to obtaining all relevant regulatory approvals. Further to resolution 8, one above, the directors be and are hereby authorized to appoint such professional parties and perform all such other acts and do such other things as may be necessary for and or incidental to the bringing into effect of the above resolutions. 9, to renew the general mandate authorizing the company to enter into recurrent transactions which are of a trading nature or those necessary for its day-to-day operations with related parties or companies in accordance with the rules of the Nigerian Stock Exchange governing transactions with related parties or interested parties, dated 12th March 2021 by order of the board, signed Oladende Nelson Cole.
Thank you very much, Mr. Nelson Cole. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for me to read a statement, for me to read my statement on the pages 13 to 15 of the annual report. However, in view of the time constraint, you may wish to consider my statement as read. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the first item on the agenda. The first item on the agenda is to lay before the members of the audited financial position with the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income for the year ended December 31st, 2020, with the reports of the directors, auditors, and the audit committee thereon, the original accounts and copies duly signed and available at this meeting for verification. I now call on the representatives of our external auditors, Mr. Femi Abigunde, to read the report of the external auditors, Deloitte and Touch, for the year ended December 31st, 2020.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, distinguished shareholders. Mr. Chairman, I would like to seek permission of shareholders to read in the very first paragraph, which is opinion, and the last one, which is our concluding remarks, in view of the fact that this publication has been sent to them earlier. Do I have your permission, sir, Zama? Thank you, sir. Independent auditor's report to the shareholders of Adova PLC. Report on the audit of the consolidated and separate financial statements. Opinion. We have audited the accompanying consolidated and separate financial statements of Adova PLC and its subsidiaries, set out in pages 42 to 94, which comprise the consolidated and separate statements of financial position as of 31 December 2020, and the consolidated and separate statements of profit or loss and other comprehensive income, consolidated and separate statements of changes in equity, consolidated and separate statement of cash flows for the year then ended, and the notes to the consolidated and separate financial statements, including a summary of significant accounting policies. In our opinion, the consolidated and separate financial statements give a true and fair view of the consolidated and separate financial position of Adova PLC as at 31 December 2020, and its consolidated and separate financial performance and consolidated and separate statement of cash flows for the year then ended in accordance with the International Financial Reporting Standards, the Corporate, the Companies and Allied Matters Act, and the Financial Reporting Council Act. Page 41. We expressly state that, one, we have obtained all the information and explanation which, to the best of our knowledge and belief, were necessary for the purpose of our audit. Two, the group and the company has kept proper books of account so far as appears from our examination of those books. Three, the group and the company's financial position and its statements of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. One. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Abegunde. I now call on the chairman of the audit committee, Mr. Olusola Adeyo, to read the report of the audit committee. Mr. Adeyo.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Before I read the report, may I please crave the indulgence of shareholders to introduce the members of the committee, without whose support we would not have had as good and productive a report, and whose commitment I personally wish to seize this opportunity. Mrs. Adebisi Oluyewayemisi Bakare, Chief Sefiu Okunola, Mr. Mohammed Aminu Umar, and Mrs. Aniola Drosimieti. I express my personal appreciation to every one of you. Now to the report. In accordance with the provision of Section 4047 of the Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020, we, the members of the Audit Committee of Adova PLC, having carried out our statutory functions under the Act, hereby confirm that the accounting and reporting policies of the company are in accordance with legal requirements and agreed ethical practices. In our opinion, the scope and planning of the audit for the year ended 31 December 2020 were adequate. The external auditor's findings on management letters and management responses thereto were satisfactory. We have kept under review the effectiveness of the company's system of accounting and internal controls, dated this 1st of March 2021. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Adeyo. Question and answer. The executive team and I will be pleased to answer any questions which you have on the audited financial position together with the comprehensive income for the year ended 31st, 2020, and the report of the auditors thereon, now before the meeting. If you have any questions, it will help if you could refer to the page of the annual reports and accounts to which your question relates. I will suggest that members should be brief in their comments and restrict questions to one to afford other opportunity for the other members. Mr. Patrick.
The chairman of the board, members of the boards of directors of our company, my fellow shareholder, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I say good morning, sirs and ma.
Good morning.
The chairman, it is with great delight that we have gathered once again to examine the financial report. My name is Patrick Ajudua. To examine the financial report of the company. And I wish to state unequivocally that for us as shareholder representatives, we want to commend the board and management for the sustainability of a positive bottom line despite the pandemic and difficult time that we have found ourselves. Mr. Chairman, we also want to bring to your notice our joy that despite this, you are still giving us a dividend of 19 kobo. Mr. Chairman, I want to appreciate you and the board. Mr. Chairman, when you are introducing the members of the high table there, you call on company secretary and say, company secretary. But here in the annual report, it's acting secretary. There is a missing link, Mr. Chairman. So we'd like to hear from you whether you have listened to our call in the last annual general meeting. Maybe that was why you decided to say we have a full-scale company secretary now. Can you please confirm that?
I'm very sorry, it was a typo. Mr. Oladeyinde Nelson Cole is a full company secretary.
Thank you very much. On behalf of the shareholders, Mr. Chairman, we want to thank you because you have shown, you have listened to us. Mr. Cole has been a wonderful company secretary since appointed, and he has been mediating between the board and the shareholders. And every request, calls, SMS made to him, he replied immediately. We appreciate him, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, when you look at the account, the quarter four 2020, where you state in your, on page 14, where you stated in your report, you commissioned the construction of a 20,000 metric ton of LPG storage facility in Ijora as a commitment to cleaner energy. The LPG signaled the foray into auto gas solution as an alternative to gasoline. My question to you, Mr. Chairman, is how focused, and I repeat, how focused is the board in acquiring a large market share in the projected 3 to 5 million tons of LPG demand for 2025. So we would like to know how you want to position yourself in this regard. On page 18, Mr. Chairman, is the issue of transport and logistics of products. You have resolved it by launching a haulage subsidiary called Azos and Cartage Limited as a stopgap to product delivery. Mr. Chairman, my question is that from experience, this venture have been a very high, have a very high attendant risk. Product diversion and adulteration, frequent accident resulting in loss of life and products. Therefore, I'm asking, do you think, sir, that we should also exploit other means of product delivery, such as train, to reduce the risk, the constant training, supervision, and monitoring of drivers and product delivery? In some of the companies of your competitor, this sector is isolated completely from the company. It's a kind of private arrangement because the company will not want to get too much involved. When you look at page 21 already, you will see the position of this same company that we are talking about with a loss of 205 million. Therefore, do we have hope to reposition this company for greater efficiency and effectiveness in service delivery? So I'm throwing it to you because you have acquired 100% of it. Taking cognizance of all that I've said, give us assurance, sir, that this step you have taken is of a great assurance to us as a shareholder. Mr. Chairman, when you look at the account on page 42 to 44, we saw an improvement in the top line from 176 billion to 181. There was a massive draw in the middle line, which is the profit before tax, by 37.8%, and the bottom line by 52.5%. The financial report shows some distortion in the growth of the company. With a 52.5% drop in the bottom line, this shows that there is need to rethink the business model. The decline in profit before tax is attributable to a significant drop in operating profit, which occur as a result of decline in investment property rental income. And when you check the current ratio, the ideal ratio for this sector is 2.0. Whereas in 2020 financial report, Mr. Chairman, we're having 0.98/1.21. This implies that what I'm saying is that under the current ratio, yeah, the ideal ratio for the industry sector you have is about 2.0. But what we're having in this report is about 0.98 1.98 against 1.21 last year, which was an improvement, but it declined this year. This implies that we still need to do more in managing our working capital. Mr. Chairman, the significance of this is that we must do more to manage our working capital. This shows that the group has some liquidity challenges, and covering its short-term liability will be a more challenging way. That was why I take you to your special resolution on page 10, which has to do with your request for a capital raising of over 60 billion. So while we appreciate it as a kind of repositioning the company, Mr. Chairman, what is your plan for the use of this money, for the application of this fund when you have raised it? The liability, of course, is also increasing, and we have to watch it. Mr. Chairman, I want to commend the lubricant deal with Shell. It is noteworthy as its major distributor. This, no doubt, will improve revenue from lubricants. Another commendation is the deal to acquire Enria Retail and Logistics Limited. This, in no doubt, when completed, will make the company a major force in downstream sector. Mr. Chairman, but my question is, we can link the two success above to the issue of your nationwide rollout of retail service station and rebranding. What are you doing to accelerate? And I say it again, what are you doing to accelerate the rate of completion of these service stations? The service stations are of major importance to us, and we look forward to hearing from you. On page 73 is the revenue segmentation. And when you look at that revenue, Mr. Chairman,
Patrick,
I'll be rounding up very soon, sir.
Please, yes.
When you look at the revenue, Mr. Chairman, we'll see that fuel constitutes more than 90% of our revenue. I will want to commend the company for being the top seller of PMS sales volume among its peers in the major oil marketing company of Nigeria. But Mr. Chairman, you must look at the lubricants. It dropped. And also, we'd like to hear from you your new venture in terms of renewable energy. Because I understand that you have discontinued the old one, so you are now in the new one. While we want to commend you and the board, I will request, Mr. Chairman, that government itself should look for a way of not interfering in price regulation. I am a supporter of full deregulation of the downstream sector, because that in itself will help the sector and will liberalize the sector. Thank you, and may God bless you, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. Patrick Ajuda. May I call on Mr. Boniface? But I'll plead, Mr. Patrick, you took all our time. I'll suggest other members do better than Mr. Patrick. Yes. Thank you very much.
Mr. Chairman, I want to commend you for being timely to hold this AGM at this time. I think you are the third company for the year holding AGM, if I'm not mistaken. That shows that this board have been proactive in dealing with the business. I could remember when you took over, we gave approval to change the name. It was immediately followed up, and we have seen the branding all over the places. If you go to Bagada Express, that's a world-class stations. At Airport Road, it's also a world-class. And I believe vividly that we also across board, all over the State Federation, that we see such a class filling station. People were happy to do business and have a clean fuel to drive their cars and their gas in their homes. That is what energy is about. A new opening, a new Vestas, energy for a brand new world. That clearly the picture shows we are in business of gas, oil and gas, and clean energy. I want to commend you for that. Patrick alluded that, yes, I was the one moved that when we have acting company secretary does not aspire to do business with such an organization. And today, it has been confirmed, it's a substantive company secretary. The board is a listening board, and the chairman have open ear to listen when we complain. I commend you for that. Keep it up. So no relenting. And when we speak here, the board implement and management follow everything we have said. Mr. Chairman, on notice convening the meeting, yes, 60 billion is not over. 60 billion, round figure. We want to approve these resolutions. And I want also to see proactive that after taking the resolution to the approver, that the board go back to work and implement it as soon as, so that we can raise money to do all things we need to do. Because 19 cobalt dividend is not where we ought to be at all, at all. Dover cannot be paying cobalt, 19 cobalt, no way. If you are taking off 19 naira, I can understand. Yes, that's what it should be in naira terms, our dividend payout. That's what company should be. Mr. Chairman, it also have affected the price movement, you know, which we are not happy. But I believe that the company is in the process of re-engineering. And that would give the room for that 19 cobalt. Because everything, today you are competing with your regulators. And NPC is a competitor, it's a marketer. And what they should be regulating? They should all buy into the market and compete. If you say you are liberalizing the oil sector, and NPC should not be a regulator. Government should find out a regulating body to regulate all of you. Not an NPC saddling, being the sole importer. And that's a problem. If you are liberating the whole things and open it, throwing it open, we should also be importing directly, since we don't have a refinery here working in Nigeria. All of us should be importing, giving a license to import. That's it. It can sell at any price. If you're importing and it's a lower price and it's a clean, anybody can drive over, buy. That is what I'm going to buy, my fuel. If it's higher, I drive to other police station and buy. That's how it should be. Not any NPC be the sole importers. So government is not doing much at all, at all. So that market liberalization must be too open for everybody to compete in. And that's where the business has been today, where we have found ourselves. It's not good enough. It is not good enough. So who is fixing the price? Is it an NPC or the government itself? You know, NPC is a government agency. And that's why they keep, you know, making loss on a daily basis, year in, year out. They both lost. Our commonwealth, they are stealing the money. But thank God they have a company like this, no matter how small it is. And they must take something home pay. So we must commend you, Mr. Chairman. The terrain you have found yourself is not easy one. That's a problem. That's a challenge. We must speak the truth to the authority, to the power that be. They have to change and allow liberalization to work the way it ought to be. Mr. Chairman, taking your statement on page 15, the NGO today we have is another one of the cleanest. If you see their outlet, is the best. How far have you gone to actualize these acquisitions? Because I know it's going to add value to Adova to bring, if not one of the best or one of the biggest in the industry today. You need to tell us in Russia how far you have gone. Not in the bid we have commenced. How far have you gone? In the next 6 months, are we anticipating that this acquisition will be completed? So we need to know thing about that. Enyo is a good one. I know that Dover can always go for the best, not second-hand clothing. No. Go for the best, and that's the best. I've seen their station at, if I where I live, is supposedly there, very world-class at Ikorodu Express, at least after my 12th bridge. You know. If you go to, what's it called, you know, after this bridge, at where you apply on daily basis, I think along Long Bridge. You know. Yes, you know. So, Mr. Chairman, on page 33, Okay, let me take you to page 23, corporate governance. That's excellent. All the subcommittees, board attendance is excellent. The board have been proactive on that. Mr. Chairman, donation on page 33. You see, on this COVID, our whole corporate body responsible, when they call CAVI, all the corporate, they lump you together and begin to give those donations, what have you. If companies have chosen their shareholders to give this palliative, it would have been a good one. Than when you give government, they store it in warehouse. That's what they looted at NSAS. I'm telling you honestly. Because all you need to call the registrars and through company secretary, tell to our member that those members who are finding difficult to leave due to COVID, if you are giving them those donations, they would appreciate you. Because people will know that companies have performed their social responsibility to their corporate world, to the shareholder of members. Mr. Chairman, it could have been a long way that given to the government. At the end of the day, we can't get to the masses where they throw aggregate bread, rise off, you know, the beast to play ball on the field. That's what we can get for the government. It's very unfortunate, sad. We can laugh over it. That tells you the kind of government we have today. They are not responsible to us. But the corporate world has shown in the magnanimous, the resilience in way of doing things, should be able to accommodate their own downturn among members or shareholders. All fingers are not equal. That's the lowest in our midst who cannot afford two square meals. You must reach out to them. If we are asking, we're not to live at wish. 19 Kobo, dividend. My brother, I'm talking, please. I'm going to round up. I'm not like Patrick, my brother, who spoke earlier. I'm going to round up as soon as possible. So, Mr. Chairman, I commend 79 million. It's not easy. We're giving out, you know, for society in which we operate. But government must also reciprocate by giving you a tax relief and all the things you are doing. That's the way to approach the company. Mr. Chairman, I will also on page 43, we should look at cost of doing business. Yeah. You know. Huh? Yes. Mr. Chairman, I am not also happy. Yes, there's a prudent finance cost, 1.5 billion. I think the 60 billion will take care of this going forward in finance cost. Finance income is also went down. Why? When we deposit for the banks, you know. These are things we'll be looking to look at, you know. I know the board are addressing this issue. We are not happy as well by this financial cost. And that's why, you know, you are proposing this resolution today so that we'll go to the market, be right issue. But I believe the right issue of public offering combination so that shareholder will not be shortchanged, will not be lost out. Because I know the engineering will going to affect everyone. We must key in to also participate in this offering so that people will not take over our own right. Because looking at this board, looking at the management, everybody and here, we want to participate, that this is a transparent board, transparent management, so that we want to be a partaker of what we are doing. Mr. Chairman, I'm looking at the reserve earnings on page 42. I'm not combining them. Reserve earnings, retained earnings, and share premium. We must also look at rewarding shareholders in future. We must do that as soon as possible. Mr. Chairman, I am rounding off from here so that I can give room for others to make their comments. Finally, no. Yes. Finally, page 74. I'm running up there. 74, I'm running up there. Mr. Chairman, auditors, please, 38 million. As again, 34. That is not acceptable. This increase must run down. Don't rush it. Gradually, we'll get there. Please. Legal professional expenses, Mr. Chairman, we should watch that. 481 million, as again, 387. We need to watch that. Every other things, 8.3 billion in last year, in 2019, then 7.2 billion. I think this management and board are watching cost of doing things. I want to applaud you that the best is yet to come. And I also commend the Barrettal registrars. They have been wonderful. They have been good, excellent. Mr. Chairman, continue to cooperate with them, with the company secretary. As the earlier speaker said, Nelson, when I call, he doesn't take my, I would take him to the cleaner. You have a bad day, and you respond. In fact, he missed that missed call, and he had to call back. Mr. Boniface, I missed your call. I was just, that's how it should be. Not being elusive. Such. We fail each other. If you are transparent, we commend you. If you are that you have caused our trouble. God bless Adova and God bless shareholder. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Boniface. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to call on Sir Sonny Wosu.
Mr. Chairman of the Board of Adova PLC, which reminds us of what the company was bearing before. You know, so it's not far from it. I want to congratulate you for your humility. That's elders do not decode things anyhow. And I congratulate you again for your humility. Mr. Chairman, one thing about the report with us is that the board and management manage the administration costs and everything about the company. It did not go haywire to an extent that it will eat too deep into the profit. I'd like to take that page 74, which my brother mentioned, age and produce losses. Why I'm picking this is that I'm also in the industry. As you know very well, we must learn from some of the good things from other places. Insurance policy that you are thinking of should include consequential losses. To have consequential losses separately from the insurance. Once you are taking general insurance on our assets and other things, consequential losses must be included in it. If you look at the amount of money involved here, 559 million naira, it's a lot of money. Small. So I want the board and the management to look at that and see how far we can save. Because you know, the major product that we deal with is evaporating. And therefore, from the ship there by the time. So all that must be taken into consideration so that we do not continue to lose so much on that. Mr. Chairman, I also want to pick the subsidiary that we have mentioned. That's on page 21. The subsidiary, and I believe one of the speakers, also, good. So for any successful subsidiary to start making profit, it is estimated at 3 years. It is estimated at 3 years. So what we have seen this year of the accounting period will now be taken into consideration. So please take note of that. Don't throw away the subsidiary because definitely at the dot of 3 years, even 2 years, we'll be seeing some signs of the success from it. It's very important.
Mr. Sonny, I can tell you Q1, the subsidiary.
My experience. Now, talking about Enyo, forget about what my brother Boniface has said. When the real 419 people were successful, what they do, in this room they will decorate it so well, when you get in, you will say, oh, this is the right place to do business. Once they take away your money, you come here, the landlord will tell you, we don't know what you are talking about. Some of the stations of Enyo cannot be like the one that Boniface patronizes. It cannot be. Now, again, there could be some very serious problems hidden somewhere. You must bring in a good expert to take a proper look of the whole thing before we go into the place. 60 billion naira. I want to believe that it's also a preparation to be able to accommodate whatever investment we want to do. I want to see it from that angle. But we also need to be very careful in coming to the market. Government has actually put in a lot of fears into investors' pain with all the useless, taking over unclaimed dividend of 6 years, taking over this, discouraging investment. So please, when you are coming, one, the price must be right. Two, you must ensure it's a double-head issue. And even if possible, it can be a triple-head issue by getting some people on a special placement to take a special placement. And also, you also have another one for shareholders to take rights before the public offer. With these three areas of intention, it is not good for us to have under subscription. Because the present Kama even is tackling the issue of capital base, which is unsubscribed. When you have unsubscribed volume of shares, it goes a long way to affect the credibility of the business. So, Anade Oshun's father was an expert in that. His late father was an expert in that. And I think he should also learn from some of the legacies of his late father. Mr. Chairman, on page 18, you told us that we have over 200 trucks, which we are presently managing. But because of fraudulent acts, we must ensure that there is trackers installed on those vehicles. So at any given time, you will be able to know where they are and what has happened to them. Let us quickly go to page 72. I know somebody talked about it, but I also want to point out certain things that he made a summary. Chairman, if you look at that table, which speaks out about everything. Now, solar system. The problem in Nigeria today is electricity problem. Solar system should be encouraged to help. And if you look at it very clearly, last year we had 700 million naira deficit. This year we are having 1,600 and so, which means 1,647 million naira. What is wrong with that business? It is just very important that we have to take another look on that business. And Mr. Chairman, somebody also talked about lubricant. If you look at last year, we made a whooping 1,500 and something from the lubricant. Why this year we are making 677? Mr. Chairman, lubricant is one of the best business in upstream operation. What are we? Are we downstream or upstream? Downstream operation. Lubricant, because it's not under control. So we should work harder to ensure that we do well on the lubricant side. Mr. Chairman, when we look at page 94, which tells us 5 years, summary and all this and that. Mr. Chairman, I want to agree with Boniface that if we had made 1,420 naira as one naira 1.242 as earning per share, and we have been given 19 kobo. CFO, you have not done well for the shareholders because you are the one who recommend to the management, and management will now recommend to the board. Even though the chairman said, I and the board is recommending 19 kobo, which I want to say is not a good statement because the board is not different from the chairman. The board recommended 19 kobo. Not, I don't want to hold the chairman personally for that, because in a statement here, he said, I and the board. In another statement, he said, the board. So I want to say it is the board that is responsible to us. But 1.42, 19 kobo, that's not good at all. That's not good. And see the healthy, on that same page, is showing the healthy reserve that we are having. Most companies that find it difficult to pay what they feel will make their shareholders happy through operational process will touch the reserve and pay shareholders and make them happy, knowing fully well that it is the best for the shareholders. I don't know whether that's a dividend policy, CFO. If that is the dividend policy, you have to advise the board. That policy must be changed. It has to be changed. Mr. Chairman, let me just quickly round up this meeting on with page 62 to 63. 62 to 63, I am very worried about receivables, other trade receivables, and other receivables. Mr. Chairman, I once said it, that the receivables is a conduit that fraud is used to, I mean, they perpetuate fraud through receivables in companies. And that was exactly what happened to Cadbury in those days. They sell invoice. At the end of the year, 31st December, these things are returned back, you know. Now, we stand the risk of losing 7 billion naira from trade receivable and other receivables. So please look at it. We need to be very careful about it. 7 billion naira, it's a huge amount of money for the company. If you look at it, already you have provided under other receivables, we have provided 5.6 billion naira, 100%. Now, if you go to trade receivable, we have also provided 1.6 billion naira. There are other receivables. So there's need for the board to explain to shareholders, how do we come about all this? It is very, very important for a better understanding of what has happened, so that we'll be very, very careful, Mr. Chairman. On that note, Mr. Chairman, I want to thank you, the board and the management, for choosing me to be one of those that will represent the larger shareholders of this company. Mr. Chairman, I also would like to ask you that you should do everything to encourage this door-to-door delivery, because that will help. Apart from helping, there will be an assurance to whoever is patronizing us that they are buying the genuine diesel. Mr. Chairman, I want to see our stations look like the one Boniface mentioned, which is not ours. It's not ours. When it was being built, we were very hopeful that it's our own. Until it was opened, we discovered that it's not our own. I thought if it were possible, just hold on. That, yes, that big one there, it's wearing our color. Yeah, is no. Anyway, there's one, they are very imposing. Very imposing with our color. So, but I look forward to see such a big structure being built by AP. And God will strengthen us. God bless every shareholder of AP, and God bless the board and management for the good job. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you very much. May I call of Chief Timothy at this year?
The chairman, members of the board of ADOVA, distinguished fellow shareholders, both present here and those watching us virtually, I say good morning. Yes, I appreciate the efforts of this company for all you have done. And I would like to refer you to page 33 of this annual report. On page 33, of this annual report, you will see the various donations which the company has made. And in particular, I want you to take note of the donation which the company has made on COVID-19. The company has been very proactive and have assisted the Lagos State government in the donation towards the COVID-19 pandemic to the tune of 50 million. Apart from this, palliative donation of 10,000 parts of food, which my friend Boniface has said has not reached the shareholders. But generally, we appreciate the efforts of this company by being part of the efforts of the government to combat the ravaging COVID-19. Apart from this, I also would like on page 14, the item under corruption, risk doors. Our business resilience shown through as we delivered exceptional sustainability, brand, core asset optimization, our people, and strategic partnerships. 2020 reflects our full year performance following our transformational journey that began in June 2019. I appreciate the efforts of this company for being very proactive. You took over, and at the time you took over, many people thought that because the people maintaining or running the business before have gone, the company might go into oblivion. But you people that took over really show resilience, and we shareholders appreciate you, even though the dividend has not been showing that. So, and also, we appreciate the efforts you are making now to bring in from shareholders a sum of 60 billion in order to improve the commitment of the company. The company has remained the catalyst for energy sufficiency in Africa. We appreciate this for this also. And in the area of corporate governance principles, you have really shown the lead. And the chairman himself, being a protagonist of corporate governance, is really showing this in the activities of the company. We thank you and pray that the Lord will continue to be with you. Thank you. God bless you all.
Thank you very much, sir. Pastor Alex Adio.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Alex Adio, A. Alex is the name. Once again, I thank you for this privilege, and I'm going to make good use of this time, even though I'm used to 45 1 hour. Yes, sir. So, Mr. Chairman, I'm going to compress everything. I'm standing on the assisting protocol. I'm looking at page 13 through to 16 and to 18, where you have your chairman's, where we have our chairman's statements to CEO. And I'm looking directly at the business performance 2020. It has been enumerated as much as possible. I'm going to have a repetition, but a little bit of emphasis. Commissioning of the 20 metric tons, fantastic. New product, Super V. I don't know if new product, the name Super V should just be new product. I remember I used it in the early 70s for my bike. I used to buy it five naira. I don't know whether you are not the one bringing the Super V name. It has been in existence for some time. But now it's a new product on our list. Is it? Am I right? Aha! I remember I buy Super V. Oh, yes. Floating haulage and transport subsidiary, like it has been mentioned. And I put here intending acquisition of NU. I think the right word is the intending. If after the other time you have made up your mind. And I look at the revenue that grew by 2.9%. At the company level, the shareholders' fund grew by 11.9%, retained earnings by 24%, is at 24%, and for business, which is 90% contribution to our gross earning. This resulting to 19 kobo dividend. It looks small, Mr. Chairman, but it's a good start. It's a good start. It's a direction that at least it will be better. It will not be coming down. So keep it up. I thank you for that. I move quickly to observations to make it fast. Well, we have spoken about the subsidiary. Still look at it very well. You have given us the idea now that it will pick up. But I've seen in many areas that particular subsidiary, you have to look at it very well and critically. It's always a drain to some other companies. So if it's not a thing you just overlook, somebody must be there to watch very well the type of people that you'll be dealing with there. That's just an advice. I look at the corporate governance, fantastic the attendance, but I see that the members there are not designated. Or maybe the position of chairman is exclusively reserved for our overall chairman. So because somebody is number one, that does not necessarily mean he's the chairman. So next time, if you can put it for us to have a better understanding of it. If I'm too fast for you, please let me know. Page 42, as note 28.3. And that has to do with consolidated and separate financial positions under loans and prepayment. But if you follow it up to page 89, that note is missing, 28.3. On page 42, the same position, but I relate it to page 90 now, note 29.2. Explain. Inventory accruals. I want you to explain that, please. Because I can see the movement from 6 to 15. So I'm looking at that direction that maybe we need to clean our books at some level. Then my advice, let's watch the totality of our expenses. It's better, that is page 43, note 73. And page 43 to page 73 and 74. But I'm particular about page 74 now, admin expenses. I see two things there, which are under admin expenses on page 74. the board and AGM expenses. I'll prefer if you separate it some other time. Let's have a clear idea of what goes for what, please. And I see there, bad and uncollectible debts. I don't know whether that's a new term. Is it that bad, doubtful, or something? So can we make it straight? If it's as good as being bad, let it be bad. Make provision, clean your books. Quickly on page 85, note 22B, I see prepayments there. And there is an item there, prepaid staff expenses. Can you explain that as well? Page 85, note 22B, prepaid staff expenses. Under prepayment, but you will see prepaid staff. I'm trying to be fast. If you want me to open that, will take some time since you prepared this document. I'm going to round up on page 39 and page 10. And my page 39 has to do with the audit matters. And I'm giving this advice. Let us take it serious, no matter what external auditors' way of addressing issue. They are telling us that, look at this area very well. So let's do that. And finally, on page 10, which is special business 8, raising of 60 billion. Of course, we are going to approve this, but please, the only area that brings fear to shareholders is the word convertible. Convertible. You know that is convertible, that is non-convertible. But the convertible aspect of it, in most cases and our experience, is not to the advantage of minority shareholders. And most of our investments went down the drain when we do it that way. I'm not saying don't do it, because this coverage is so wide, and that's the way we are doing it in Nigeria. I would have loved in Nigeria that a company to come out and say, this is what I intend to do. That is where you know where you are going. But we'll give you the cover as usual. But please take notice. The word convertible there looks like poison to minority shareholders if it's not well played. Thank you very much. God bless you, sir. Thank you.
Pastor Samson Olagoke. Again, I will indulge our members to be brief. I think time is far spent. Please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. All the members, my co-shareholder, and my fathers. My name is Pastor Samson Olusegun Olagoke. My own speech is in another dimension. My father have already, you know, people have already talked about the accounts. But Yoruba says, yini yini, ganishe me. I commend the chairman, all the board, and management for an excellent transparency account we are considering today. And I wonder why. Why it is so? I went to the page 20 to 29. And I confirm that we have competent boards, intelligent business tycoon, and quality boards. Please keep it up. My own commendation, another commendation is going to the Office of Company Secretariat. In presence of Mr. Nelson Cole, he's doing a wonderful job. Very accommodative, friendly to the shareholders and stakeholders. And others, they are doing very well. Now, people have talked about the raising of funds. We will give you support. We'll pass the resolution. Lastly, I commend our audit committee for the opportunity given to me.
Thank you very much for being very brief. Mrs. Esther Augustine.
At last. But they said lady first. But because of my oga here,
apologies.
I took the lady last. Good morning, Mr. Chairman. Good morning.
Madam.
Mr. Chairman, a lot I've said about the account and associated myself with the earlier speakers. The one that remains is about unclaimed dividends. Sir Sonny also have mentioned earlier that there are some people at the corner who want to live on our unclaimed dividends, which will not be possible for them. So we should do something. If it is to print the names of those people affected, so they will know they have money with us, and they will do what they can to claim their dividends. Another thing is about I saw the cooking gas here, Mr. Chairman. No woman will not go for this because it's beautiful. Thank you. And I saw something last week in my area. Coport, they took it down at grassroots. They be giving people, you will be paying instrumentally. So if we can make it possible for people to buy, think they will go for it. We can use another style of selling our cooking gas in grassroots. Many people will purchase it. Is it available at our filling stations? I want to know. If it is so, we can use another dimension to make it make it available for other people to know about it. I know we have gas cooker everywhere, but how are we marketing it so for people to know about it, sir? Mr. Chairman, we thank you very well. The time you came in, sir, my thought was that, can we able to take dividend from this company again? Many people have sold their shares from many companies because the dividend has not been given. But this year now, I really appreciate you, sir, because many people will give excuse on COVID-19 that is why they did not pay dividend this year. But whatever you gave us, we appreciate it. If it is small, we appreciate it. But I know by the grace of God, in the nearest future, you are going to pay more than the one you have given now, by the grace of God. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much, Madam Esther. We've taken note of all the questions. I'd like to invite the CFO the CEO, first of all, to deal with the ones pertaining to business operation.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I stand on existing protocols. There were quite a few questions there, and I've tried to cluster them in real time as possible. I'll deal with the operational ones, and then I will hand over to our CFO to come through. So I think the first person that spoke spoke about spoke about the strategy for LPG, and also had some commentary around ANC, the our logistics business. I would like to say that on the logistics business, the intention has never been and will not be to move 100% of our transport and logistics in-house. The idea is to provide ownership and coverage for a subset, because just as, the points you raised around the lack of control, theft, pilferage, is better controlled inside than when you outsource it. So for a subset of our business operations, Mr. Paul, we are quite comfortable that the amount that we have in-house, which accounts for less than a third, in fact, less than 25% of what we would usually use, is sufficient for us. In terms of management and operations, we have put in sufficient safeguards so that we are seeing the management of those trucks in real time, or even on a kilometer by kilometer basis. To the point that Sir Sonny made earlier, we have also invested in tracking devices. They come in built as part of these trucks. So at any given point in a truck's journey, we know where it is, and we have journey managers that establish communications with them in real time. The overhead to us is no different from what it would have been if we outsourced it to third parties. It's just that we have better control over that facility. And I think the chairman has already made the point earlier. Yes, there was a 200 million loss reported in Q1, startup year. But in Q1 2020, we're already in the black. So that investment is clearly paying off. And we intend to do absolutely everything within management's control to make it to continue to that, so for that to continue to be the case. I think there were some questions around PAT and PBT that Mr. Paul made, but I would like to suggest to the gentleman that he neglected the one-off items that were included in the 2019 report. And I think if you take those one-off items out, it will be very clear to you that this is a 45% jump in profit after tax and a 55% jump in profit before, or 46% jump in profit before tax. So I just wanted to clear that that particular point up. Thank you. It's been very encouraging to hear the support for the bond. Rest assured that the uses of funds are as you understand them, and we remain accountable to the board to make sure that those funds are judiciously used, treated as capex items to create future value for our company. I would like to make a small correction that was made on Shell. I think someone said that we are a major distributor of Shell products in Nigeria. I just wanted to clarify that we are the exclusive distributors of Shell products in Nigeria, so that there is very little competition in that market. So, Mr. Boniface, you made a very good point on the conflicting role of our regulators, competitors, supplier. You're absolutely correct, sir. The discussions to align and to realign those aspects, those relationships, are ongoing, but it creates for a very difficult market to continue to have those dynamics. And all the efforts that are being pushed, both as from us as major manufacturer, major oil marketers, and efforts from other stakeholders in the business, are to push to really resist the dominance of NNPC in this space. So it's my firm belief that if we continue to mount the pressure and we see some grounding in regulation with the PIB, we will be on to what may look like a much more level playing field. But in the meantime, we continue to act as a pressure group, and we continue to push the government to render the best version of itself in this particular area. You wanted an update on Enyo. Given the I think the announcement that was made was that we were looking to complete due diligence. I can confirm that we are nearing the end of that process. And other documentation that you'd expect to find in this kind of deal are also being negotiated, and we're really getting close to the end of that process. If you'll forgive me, that's all I think I can divulge at this stage. But sir, I was a bit upset at how lovingly you spoke of that other NU station. I was. You spoke too lovingly of that station. Meanwhile, this is our shareholders meeting, sir. So I would urge that you... we have a station in Ikorodu, sir. If I have to come down there and give you a personal tour, I'll be more than happy to do so, sir. But I would encourage you to visit that station in Gbagada that has been spoken of. I would also encourage you to visit our solar-powered station in Oniru, which you'll find is a very fine example of an Adova PLC retail station. The rollouts are continuing, but we've heard the point that was made on the pace of progress. But for the slowdown in matters, thank you. I'm just trying to take a page out of your book. But for the slowdown in matters, would have been done. On lubricants, I think there was a point there being made that we should thank you for recognizing our dominance in the PMS space. It has the result of great effort, great focus, really managing every molecule of products that we pushed across the board. We will not relent, and we'll continue for that to be the case. On lubricants, On lubricants, actually, the market itself contracted because of COVID. So the overall volume that was available for sale was low, and we still managed to take a large chunk of it. And if you look at the records, we increased our market share. We recognize that there is a dominant player in this field, and the entire purpose of bringing in a Shell lubricant to the table is so that we are able to compete directly, head to head, with the best in class of that product set. And we expect that over the course of this year, as we push out the grades, which are now in country, the first batches in country, we'll start to see a lot more attack from us on that market share so that we bring more of it home. There was talk to the chairman on humility. There were some good words that I'm going to move from. There was a point that Sir Sonny made on shrinkage. I will leave the CFO to talk through the detail, but actually what you're seeing there, it really is an effect of the price increase and the valuation of that shrinkage rather than an actual increase in shrinkage. So that number, yes, it looks high, but that's because we just priced it based on the adjustments to price that were made in the year 2020. The points you made on the due diligence and making sure that we know absolutely what we're buying. Having paid the school fees, sir, we are even more focused on that. On that, we have learned the lesson, and we are really looking at this with all of the pairs of eyes that we can to make sure that we make the right purchase for this company. We've done that, trackers on vehicles. Page 12. So Sasoni also had some comments on revenue from solar. I just wanted to point out that some of the numbers that you were citing, sir, were slightly different from the numbers that we have. What we did in losses last year on the solar was 695,000 naira. And that, again, is aligned up with our strategy to wind down and sunset what we have already. Now, what we have that's coming in now, because like you, we do believe that solar has a large market to play in the future, and the market is huge and very addressable by us. One of the things that I think goes unnoticed is when we say that we have now put solar in the stations, is what that means is that we are now also making money from the power that we sell to the stations. So we may not be seeing income from the sales of those solar, but we are actually collecting revenue for selling power to the station. So there's some revenue coming in through there. And then some of the other initiatives that we have been speaking to over the past year, such as the battery as a service, which really starts to deal with the 100 million people that are not connected to the grid, that can have affordable power, 2,000, 3,000 a month. That is what we're looking to address now. And the pilot version of the battery as a service proposition is in country today. And you start to see the rollout. Just you are starting to see the rollout of the AP stations nationwide. Trade receivables. I'll leave our CFO to deal with that. Prepaid staff expenses. I will also leave the CFO to deal with that. Sir, the point you made so passionately on convertibles has been heard. As you rightly observed, the wording of those things is really to make sure that we cover all eventualities. But your point is heard and noted. Mrs. Augustine, thank you very much as well. I can confirm to you that we are looking to make sure that the bottles that you see and like are currently available at the stations. And we are also looking at ways to reduce the barrier to entry through financing to third parties, so that adoption they get the bottle so that they can get to the gas. So we're quite happy to put in whatever financial arrangements and relief that are necessary to make sure that we are able to sell gas more continuously. Thank you very much. Yes, sir.
good morning, everyone. Hey. Thank you very much. So I don't have to answer that question again, right? Thank you very much. I think a couple of the things here has already been taken by the CEO. The strategy for LPG has been explained about 2020. So what you're seeing there is 3 months revenue and 9 months of expenses. So that's why you're seeing what you're seeing there. There was a comment around decline in PBT. Just to clarify again, you're comparing, if we compare apples with apple, we'll remove the one-off items in 2019. There are two one-off items in 2019. There's a disposal of subsidiary that brought in about 2.6 billion in income. There's a subsidy claim that brought in about 3.9 billion. If you remove those two items, you would actually find out that you're now comparing apples with apple, and there was a significant improvement in performance in 2020 compared to 2019. Particularly if you pick some of the items that Sir Nwosu mentioned around administrative expenses, which declined by about 1 billion between 2019 and 2020. There was a question that you see is an increase in our market share in 2020 compared to 2019. However, the total volume that was available in the market to be taken dropped because of COVID. And that's because for about 3 months in 2020, there was actually no volume of lubricants out there. Where are we with the ERS deal? The CEO has taken that. There was a question around trade receivables. And I think there's about 5 or 6 questions around it. So I'll just take the trade receivable point once. Now, if you look at the breakdown of that item, there is advanced payment to suppliers constitute the significant chunk of that difference. And that's because right towards the end of 2020, we had to pay in advance for all our PMS volumes that were coming into our system. So when you take a 31st December 2020 cut off, you'll find out that we had a lot of payments to PPMC that we had not received product. So in advance payment to supplier, more than 60-70% of that figure there is payment to inventory accrual. Inventory accrual is the account that warehouses products that we have received, but we've not been invoiced for. Right? So the way our products are received in the business is, let's say we pay for 20 million liters of PMS. NNPC brings those products in trickles. So they bring 5 million, 7 million. So as those products are coming into our inventory, we're recognizing the liability for the payment of those products. However, we've not really received an invoice. That transaction has not been completed. So any product that we have received, but we have not received, we have received into our inventory, but we've not paid for, in sense that we have not received an invoice for it, is warehoused in inventory accrual. So it's an accrual for us to pay for inventory that we have received. I hope that clarifies it. It doesn't. Okay. Okay, sir. Provision no longer required. That's a different item, and I'm coming to that. I'm coming to that. Provision no longer required is different from inventory accrual. Okay, sir. Okay. Okay, so I'll take that separately. Let me take that immediately, just so that we don't lose sight of that point. Provision no longer required of 517 million. I imagine that's what you're talking about, sir. Yes, it's 517 million. Correct, it's 517 million, sir. Is that the number, sir? Okay. Now, when we recognized the promissory note for the subsidy payment from the government, right? We also recognized a provision for time value of money on the promissory note, right? So government said they're going to pay us an amount in subsidy claims. We recognized a provision against that amount, knowing that it would take some time for the government to pay it, and we took a view as to what we thought was the net amount will come to us as a result of that claim. Now, in 2020, some of those claims were actually paid. So we had to reverse that provision as a provision no longer required, because now we have received the promissory note. Now, when we discounted the promissory note, the actual finance cost as a result of the discounting is carried in our finance cost item. I hope that clarifies it. So this is a provision we made.
I think you should need to be clear. The subsidy payments were deferred payments. They were given, but they were promissory note for 4 years. You're not able to get those money until 4 years, so they were discounted. So the promissory notes were given as deferred payment, not cash.
Yes, that makes it easier. So it was when we made the claim to the government that we recognized a provision against the claim. When the claim was now made, when the promissory notes were issued, we reversed the provision as a provision no longer required. So it wasn't smoothing of any profit, or there was no game that was being played, because the actual finance cost that we incurred is carried in our finance cost line item. There was a comment around statutory auditors and the fees. Fantastic conversation. I'll really love that conversation to go on. But the reality is there was no increase of fees in the period under review. Just to draw the attention of the esteemed members of the company to the fact that we had a subsidiary during the year and there was an audit of that subsidiary. So the difference you're seeing is the audit fee for the subsidiary. And that's why when you check company for company, it's exactly the same item. It's when you check group and you compare it to company, that's where you see a differential. And that's to reflect the audit fees for Axos and Cartage. Legal and professional fees during the period, most of the things we're doing, we have to do the right due diligence. We have to get the right professional advice. Your company is in a growth phase. We're making a lot of investments. That requires us to get the right legal advice. Shrinkage and product losses, the CEO has spoken about it, but just to even clarify that, the growth here is not loss of product. It's as a result of revaluation of inventory because of price change. So this is not that 559 million of products was lost or was stolen in our system. This is NNPC changing price at their whim and caprice during the year. I think during 2020, that happened about three times. So that's what is reporting into this account. So it's not product that is lost. Solar system has been addressed by the CEO. The lubricant has been addressed by the CEO. With your kind permission, I would say that the 19 kobo dividend is what the board has recommended. there was a comment around receivable and 5.6 billion at risk. Just to clarify, sir, that the provisions you're seeing on that page are cumulative figures. So this shows amounts that have been provided against for sins that is carried in the books. So this is 5-6 years balance of all the impairments that have been made on our provision. So this is not the impairment for the current period. The impairment for the current period is on page 6074, bad and uncollectible debt. That was the figure that Pastor had drawn everybody's attention to. And your comment around whether it's uncollectible or not is noted, sir. We will look into that. Prepaid employee expenses. As part of the compensation framework within the organization, there are some prepaid amounts. So, for example, transport allowance is paid once in a year, but it's paid for a one-year period. Housing allowance and all of that. So when you accumulate it, that's the figure that is reporting. Yeah, correct. And then we amortize it on a monthly basis as the time goes by. Key audit matter, this point has been discussed in very, very good detail with the audit committee. The statutory audit committee has made their recommendations as to how we pay attention to this key audit matter. But just to clarify that this key audit matter is not an indication that there's a problem. Yes, it's just to draw attention to one of the most significant issues that the auditors dealt with during the audit. Not that issue itself is problematic, but that it's a key audit matter for the auditors. I think there was a comment around unclaimed dividends. And just to say that the company has always made funds available for the payment of dividends. We do have the list of unclaimed dividends on our website. And we also have it printed. I think the list is also available out there if anyone has anyone that might have unclaimed dividends. We are always happy and willing at every point in time, together with our fantastic registrars, to make sure that any shareholder who has dividend that has not received it can get access to the shareholders. Because as a company, we can't even use the fund, so it's of no use to us. The regulations require us to ring fence the fund and not touch it. I think I've answered all the questions. Thank you very much. They've been provided for, sir.
From the account. When anything comes in.
So they've been removed. So what you're seeing there is for full disclosure, sir. So the amounts have been completely provided for in the books. Correct, sir. Okay, sir. Okay. The point is noted, sir. That's fine, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, shareholders. I would like to add a couple of things that that I have information from the management. First of all, is that the management is undergoing some investment in asset renewal. As you may well know, the Apapa Ijora terminal has existed for over 50 years now, and those assets have gone beyond their, you know, shell life. Part of the investment that has been undertaken is the renewal and modernization of those assets. By the grace of God, in the next 18 to 24 months, Adova PLC will be having the best and the most modern terminal with increased capacity for a fully automated and increased throughput of hydrocarbon. This will increase the terminal capacity for PMS to over 52 million liters. At present, we're under 20 million. And you can imagine if we're able to do the highest volume of PMS in Nigeria, if we now have an increased capacity, you can imagine what that is. Secondly, I have information that the company is also, introducing a new product mix. In the next couple of weeks, the company will be receiving the first cargo of bitumen. This is a business that has been abandoned. We have one of the best bitumen facility, and I can tell you, the management has renovated and rehabilitated the bitumen tanks, and has also put in place loading gantries and weighbridge. In the next few weeks, I understand they will be receiving their first cargo. So this is some of the information. This is all the works that the. I agree, but sometimes you need to do some of this thing under the radar because you have so many people who, you know, don't want you to achieve those things. So sometimes. Thank you very much. There have been no further comments, and the audited financial positions and comprehensive income for the year ended December 31st, 2020, having been presented and members having made comments and notations, may I call on a member to move a motion that the audited accounts for the year ended 31st December 2020 has been duly presented and received by members. Pastor, please. Thank you, Pastor. Think. Is that acceptable by all? All right. The next item on the agenda is to consider and if thought fit, declare a dividend of 19 kobo per 50 kobo ordinary share as recommended by the board of directors and in line with section 4261 of Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020 provides that a company may in general meeting declare. I now propose that the dividend be declared, as aforementioned. Will a shareholder please second the resolution? Mr. Boniface.
Mr. Chairman, having spoken earlier about the dividend, but Mr. Chairman, I have also commented here that why should we pay tomorrow? And the register is available to dispense it today. So I... You say what? So they're available. So I've so seconded.
Thank you very much, yes. Mr. Boniface. May I now invite the register to take us through the voting exercise on the resolution?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Distinguished shareholders, The voting parts which you were earlier given to, you will now be used for voting on the respective resolutions to be read out by the chairman. For purposes of voting, shareholders are restricted only to buttons labeled numbers 1 and 2 on the pad. Button number 1 represents yes or in favor of a resolution, while button number 2 represents no or against a resolution. In order to vote, shareholders are to press the appropriate button which represents their intention. Shareholders have 20 seconds to cast their vote once they are called upon to vote. The result of the voting exercise will be displayed on the digital screen in real time, while the analysis will be generated immediately for members' view. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So shareholders may now cast their vote. No. Okay. Well, thank you. Okay, sorry, please, shareholders. We need to cast the vote again. Okay, so. Kindly vote. Okay, we have a total of 131 votes in favor of the resolution. Which is 100% in favor. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I declare the resolution carried. Re-election of director. May I now call upon the company secretary to read out the name of the director subject to re-election, please.
Director subject to re-election is Mrs. Aniola Drosimi Eti. In accordance with Article 88 and 89 of the Articles of Association of the Company, Mrs. Aniola Drosimieti will retire by rotation from the Board of Directors at this annual general meeting and, being eligible, offers herself for re-election.
Thank you, Mr. Nelson Cole. I now propose that Mrs. Aniola Drosimieti, a director retiring and being eligible, offering herself for re-election, be and is hereby re-elected. Okay. Second.
Because she's my sister.
Hello. What do you want?
I so do. I give her full support. My name is Esther Funke Augustine.
Yes. It's a Me Too world. Don't worry. There are school children here, sir. Let's off the mic. Thank you very much, Madam Esther. I now propose that Mrs. Durusimeti, a director retiring and being eligible, offering herself for re-election, be and is hereby re-elected as the director of the company. Thank you. Voted. Thank you. Yes, please. Yeah.
You may now cast your vote.
Registrar. Yeah. May I now invite the registrar to take us through the voting exercise on the resolution?
Please, just a point of correction. You know, the voting parts, you only, you're expected to only use two of them, one or two, you know. So please, thank you. We have 100% in favor of the resolution.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. I declare the resolution carried. Remuneration of auditors. The next business of the agenda is to declare and fix the remuneration of the auditors in accordance with Section 408 of Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020. I propose that the directors be and are hereby authorized to fix the remuneration of the external auditors for the year ending December 31st, 2021. Will a shareholder please second the resolution? Chief, sir.
Hi, Chief Timothy Adesina, so second.
Thank you very much. May I now invite the registrars to take us through the voting exercise on the resolution?
You may now cast your vote, please. Distinguished shareholders, I think, yes, we need to take that vote again. Thank you very much.
Sorry.
The remuneration.
Of auditors. Auditors, not directors, yes.
Auditors, please. Okay, thank you. Thank you. We may now go ahead to cast our votes. One more person, okay. We have 100% in favor of the resolution. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I declare the resolution carried. If the shareholders permit, the next one should be the election of members of the audit committee, but I believe there's going to be an election. I would suggest we put it to the last one. Let's do the other one because... Okay. Thank you very much. The nominees of the election into the audit committees are therefore six. Mr. Job Iherijirika Ogokaran. Let me just read out the names first. Mr. Adeniola Samuel, Mrs. Adebisi Bakari, Mr. Orelaja Ayodele, Mr. Safi Okonla, and Mr. Babatunde Akoni Shubande. And I'll call on the registrars to take us through the election. Sorry. Show of hands, please. So.
Call out the names.
Thank you. We received a total of 22 nominations. The validity of the nominations was determined through the inclusion otherwise of the names of the nominees and nominators of the shareholders register. In total, we had 22 valid nominations. We received 19 withdrawals and 4 invalid nominations. So we presently have 6 nominees. The first, Mr. Job Ihejirika Onwuhara, Mr. Adeniola Samuel, Mrs. Adebisi Oluwayemisi Bakari, Mr. Orelaja Ayodele, Mr. Safiu Okonla, Mr. Babatunde Akoni Shobande. These are the 6, and it will be by show of hands. So I'll start with Mr. Job Ihejirika Onwuhara. Those in favor, kindly show by show of hands. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Registrar, please.
Registrar, please.
All right, sir. Thank you. The next name here is Mr. Adeniola Samuel. Mrs. Adebisi Oluwayemisi Bakari. Mr. Orelaja Ayodele. Mr. Safiu Okonla. Thank you. And the last, Mr. Babatunde Akoni Shobande.
I now call on the registrars to take us through the election process. After the election, give us the results. To announce the results.
Thank you very much. Mr. Joe Ihejirika, 8 votes. Mrs. Adebisi Bakare, 9 votes. Safiu Akin Okunla, please. 9. And the rest are new, right?
0 votes for the
rest. 0 votes, yes. All right, thank you.
Thank you very much, Registrar. Mr. Job Ihejirika, Mrs. Adebisi Bakari, and Mr. Safiu Shovande are hereby re-elected as members of the Audit Committee for the year ended, for the year December 31st, 2021. Will the shareholder please second the resolution? Will the shareholder please second the resolution?
Mr. Chairman, let us know the 2 directors that are joining them.
Yes, I'm going to do that.
Okay.
So the 2 directors are Mr. Olushola Adeyo and Mr. Aminu Mohammed Umar. Further to section 4043.
Mr. Chairman, I want to second that motion.
Thank you
for
very
the re-election of the audit committee, because they have done more than our expectation. We appreciate
them. Thank you.
Thing. All you need to do is the constitution of the audit committee.
Thank you very much for the correction. Thank you. Remuneration of managers. The next item on the agenda is to disclose the remuneration of the managers of the company. Section 257 of Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020 stipulates that the compensation of managers of a company shall be disclosed to members of the company at the annual general meeting. This information has been, of course, provided on page 91 of the annual report, which was previously circulated to all shareholders and members present. I hereby propose that we take the disclosure as read and accepted. Thank you very much. Special business. The next item on the agenda is to declare and fix the remuneration of directors. Section 2391 of the Companies and Allied Matters Act 2020 stipulates that the remuneration of the directors shall be determined by the company in a general meeting. I now propose that the fees payable to the non-executive directors be set at the sum of 600,000 naira and the sum of 800,000 to the chairman, per annum.
Will a shareholder, I now propose that the fees payable to the non-executive directors be set at the sum of 600,000 naira and the sum of 800,000 naira for the chairman per annum. Will a shareholder? We're bringing the sector down. Okay. I believe so too, sir. Subject, exactly. I believe so too, sir, and we will consider this in 2021. Will a shareholder please second the resolution?
Okay. Adiwe Alex, I so second.
Okay.
Can I have the registrar?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman. You may now cast your votes, shareholders. Okay, Mr. Chairman, we have a total of 133 votes in favor of the resolution, which is equivalent to 100% in favor. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We declare the resolution carried. Raising of capital. The next business of the day is to consider and, if thought fit, pass the following resolutions of the company. Pursuant to Article 79 of the Articles of Association, the company be and is hereby authorized to raise capital in an aggregate amount not exceeding 60 billion naira through its issuance of shares, convertible or non-convertible securities, loan, notes, bonds, global depository notes, and any other instrument, whether or taken as read. Okay. Both are taken as read. Okay. I hereby propose that the resolution be approved. Okay, will a shareholder please second the motion?
I shall second, Mr. Chairman, the motion. Okay, Zia Boniface.
Thank you, Mr. Boniface. Register, please. May I invite the register to take us through the voting exercise of the resolution?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You may now cast your vote. We have a total of 130 votes in favor of the resolution, which is 100%. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for the enlightenment. Thank you. I declare the resolution carried. Our school joined. The next item on the agenda is to renew the general mandate authorizing the company to enter into recurring transactions which are of trading nature or those necessary for its day-to-day operations with related to parties or companies in accordance with the rules of the Nigerian Stock Exchange, governing transaction with related parties or interested persons. I now propose that the general mandate be renewed. Will a shareholder please second? Mrs. Esther.
I'd like to do that. My name is Sarson Iwosu.
Thank you, Mr. Sarson Iwosu. Thank you for
Sarson Iwosu. No, Mr.
Sir. Son, Chief Sir. May I ask the registrar to take us through?
Thank you, sir. Distinguished shareholders, you may now cast your vote. Thank you. We have a total of 133 votes in favor, which is 100% in favor of the resolution. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I declare the resolution carried. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the formal business of the annual general meeting. I now declare this meeting closed. I thank you on behalf of the board for attending the meeting and showing so much interest in the affairs of our company. I also thank the regulators, other stakeholders, and shareholders who have joined this meeting. And I'll call on Madam Esther Augustine to give us the closing prayer.
Let's pray. Our Celestial Father Jehovah, we thank you for the privilege that you have given us today to conduct our AGM. And we have done that in a peaceful way. We thank you for everything you have done for us today. Please, God, be with every one of us as we are returning home. It should be accident-free. Those one who come from far away, we want your Holy Spirit to be with them, your power to be with them, they should go home safely. Amen. We pray for our chairman that he has been sharing share of this company, that when he's going home, it should not be anything accident. Amen. Every one of us here, lead us home safely. All this thing we pray for in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.